ओके लेट्स सी अनसर्टेनिटी एनालिसिस. ओके इट्स अ डिफरेंट वे टू कैलकुलेट द एरर्स. सो वट एवर कैलकुलेशंस वी डिड इन रिलेटिव एरर एंड लिमिटिंग एरर वी हैव सॉ प्रीवियसली, इट इज द सेम थिंग बट इट्स अ डिफरेंट अप्रोच टू कैलकुलेट द एरर. ओके सो विच इज कॉल्ड एज अनसर्टेनिटी एनालिसिस. Here the formula to calculate the errors will change. Okay, so just to give you a feel, I have taken an example, that is velocity v is given as 15.6 meter per second plus minus 0.2 meter per second. So if you calculate a del v divided by v, that was your relative error, which is 0.2 divided by 15.6, that comes out to be 0.013, that is 1.3%. Here now it will be called as relative uncertainty. Okay, instead of relative error we'll call it as relative uncertainty. And this guy, which was our absolute limiting error or absolute error, now we will call it as absolute uncertainty. This was del v and this is del v divided by v, which is relative uncertainty. So relative error has been changed to relative uncertainty and absolute error has been changed to absolute uncertainty. So here absolute error means the limiting error what we are talking about. Okay, so now let's say if you add the subtract the quantities, then what will happen to the uncertainties? So these are called as uncertainties now. Okay, so let's say you have a momentum p1 and p2. One is 2.36 plus minus 0.04 kg meter per second, and okay, sorry about that. So we had P1, P2, that is 2.36 plus minus 0.04 kg meter per second, and P2 is 2.44 plus minus 0.05 kg meter per second. So let's say you are adding these quantities, then P total is P1 plus P2. So true value will be 2.36 plus 2.44. This will be 4.80, and the uncertainty we'll calculate will be like this. Del P is equal to under root del P1 square plus del P2 square. So here we are not adding the uncertainties, we are adding the squares of uncertainties and taking the under root. So that will be the uncertainty of P total. Okay, so this will be the difference from what we were studying in errors. Okay, so this will be under root 0.04, 0.04 square plus 0.05 square, that will be 0.09. so if you write properly, your p total will be 4.80 plus minus 0.09 kg meter per second. So you can see the everything is same. The way we are calculating the uncertainty, total uncertainty, is different. Previously we used to add the errors. In case of adding, add the absolute errors, but here we are adding the squares of absolute error and taking the under root of it. Okay, now you will see the same thing will happen when you subtract the two quantities. Okay, now the same thing will happen with subtracting the quantities. So if you take P1 minus P2, that is Q total, so it will be 2.36 minus 2.44, that is minus 0.08. In this case also, your uncertainty, your absolute or limiting or you can say absolute uncertainty will be under root del P1 square plus del P2 square is equal to 0.09, what we have calculated before. Okay, so if you write properly, what you'll get is Q total will be minus 0.08 plus minus 0.09 kg meter per second. So either you add or either you subtract the quantities, your uncertainties will be in this manner, means square of sum of the squares of individual uncertainty, absolute uncertainties, and taking the under root. This is in the case of adding and subtracting. Now we're gonna see multiplication also. Okay, now let's say you are having multiplication or division uncertainty. So in case of multiplication and division of quantities, what will happen to uncertainty? We will see. So So let's say your mass is given as 12.3 plus minus 0.2 kg and velocity is 5.42 plus minus 0.01 meter per second. Then momentum, that is P, is defined as m into v, product of these two. So the true value will be 12.3 into 5.42. That comes out approximately equal to 67 kg meter per second. If you will calculate the uncertainty, so here, mind you, in case of addition and subtraction, we were adding the squaring the absolute uncertainties and adding them under root them. Okay, now but here what you will do, the same thing you will do with relative uncertainty. Okay, in case of multiplication and division, you work with relative uncertainty. So square the, you take the sum of the squares of relative uncertainties and then take the under root. That will be the relative uncertainty of the momentum, you can see. Okay, this is the main formula that will work for multiplication as well as division as well. So del P divided by P will be under root del M divided by M whole square plus del V divided by V whole square. So del M divided by M means 0.2 divided by 12.3 whole square plus del V 0.01 divided by 5.42 del V divided by V whole square. That comes out to be 0.018. You don't require del P divided by P, you require del P. So you multiply P here, so you will get del P is equal to 1 kg meter per second, where P is 67 kg meter per second. Okay, so you multiply here, you will get approximately equal to 1 kg meter per second. So if you write it properly, your momentum will be 67 plus minus 1 kg meter per second. This is in the case of multiplication or division. Okay. Okay, let's see the case of division as well. So time is given as 10.7 plus minus 0.2 seconds. Distance is given as 60 plus minus 0.1 meter. So velocity will be defined as distance upon time. Distance is 60, time is 10.7. Your true value of velocity will be 5.61 meter per second. Now if you have to calculate the uncertainty, so relative uncertainty of velocity del V by V will be equal to under root relative uncertainty of distance square plus relative uncertainty of time square under root. Okay, so you plug the value under root 0.1 divided by 60 whole square plus 0.2 divided by 10.7 whole square. That comes out to be 0.0187. if you calculate del V, that is multiplying with V, multiplying with 5.61, that is 0.0187 into 5.61, that comes out to be 0.1052. So velocity, if you write properly, will be 5.61 plus minus 0.105 meter per second. So that is in the case of division. Okay, let's see the case when you have propagation of error, or you can say as uncertainty in this case. So let's say you have kinetic energy defined as half mv square, and it is given mass is 22.6 plus minus 0.1 kg and v velocity is 5.42 plus minus 0.01 meter per second. So if you plug the value of m and v, 22.6 and 5.42, you will get 332 joule kinetic energy. So that will be your true value. Now you have to calculate the absolute uncertainty. Now for that you have to know this. If you have a function f of x comma y, where x is x plus minus del x and y is y plus minus del y, then your del f will be under root del f divided by del x, that is partial derivative df upon dx, sorry, into del x whole square plus df upon dy del y whole square. Take the sum of them and under root. Remember, these term df divided by dx and df divided by dy are partial derivative with respect to function f. So that is how you calculate the absolute uncertainty in case if you have more variables. Okay, if you will have a function of xyz, then there will be a term df divided by dz del z whole square plus whole square under root. Okay, so likewise you can add more and more terms if depending upon the function. Okay, with how many variables it is defined. So the same thing I'll do here. So under root half v square is the partial derivative of the k with respect to m. So half v square into partial derivative of सॉरी एरर ऑफ मास दैट इज 0.1 होल स्क्वायर प्लस पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ के विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू वी दैट इज एम वी इंटू डेल वी 0.01 होल स्क्वायर. सिंस वी हैव ओनली टू वेरिएबल दैट इज वाई टू टर्म्स टेक द स्क्वायर प्लस अंडर रूट विच विल कम आउट टू बी 2 जूल्स. सो काइनेटिक एनर्जी विल बी रिटन एज 3332 प्लस माइनस 2 जूल्स. ओके सो दैट इज हाउ यू डील when you have more number of variables, so you propagate the error using this formula. Okay, mind you, this is partial derivatives and this is absolute uncertainties. So now let's see the derivations. So we had when f of x comma y is equal to x plus y, and your del f by partial derivative with respect to x will be 1, partial derivative with respect to y will be 1. So if you calculate absolute uncertainty of f, that will be under root df divided by dx partial derivative del x whole square plus df divided by dy del y whole square under root. Okay, so df divided by dx, df divided by dy are 1, so that will be under root dx del x square plus del y square, that is your del f. So this is what we saw initially. Okay, even if you will have x minus y, your df divided by dy will be minus 1. And here if you will plug minus 1, nothing will change because square is there. So you will again get same expression. So these are for addition subtraction. Now for multiplication division, you have f of x comma y is equal to x dot y. So del df divided by dx will be y, df divided by dy will be x. So del f is equal to under root, the same thing what we had. So del f will come out to be under root y del x del x whole square plus x del y whole square. If you divide it with f, that is x y, you will get under root del x divided by x whole square plus del f del y divided by y whole square. And this is what we saw in the case of multiplication and division. Okay, so I am not showing division, you can do that, I feel. So you will come up with same thing. If you will do x divided by y, okay, so you will have df divided by dx, df divided by dy, calculate del f, then divide it by f, you'll get the same thing. Okay, now there is some extra stuff. If you multiply with a constant, what will happen? So c is your constant, x is a variable, f of x y is equal to cx, then what will happen? Del f will be df upon dx del x, since there is no other term, so under root will cancel with this square. So df divided by dx del x, df will be c into del f will be c into del x. You can see because df divided by dx is c. Okay, that's why. So now if you divide it by f, what you will get? C del x divided by cx, that is del x divided by x. So what you can see, the relative uncertainty is not dependent upon the constant, but the absolute uncertainty is dependent upon the constant. And we saw the same thing in during absolute error and relative error as well, where we saw relative error does not depend upon the constant. So that is how you can think here as well and there as well. So but the absolute error or limiting error will depend upon the constant, just like here absolute uncertainty is depending upon constant. Okay, but relative error is not. So that is how you can frame whatever we saw. Okay, I'll summarize everything. So just to compare, in the limiting error case, you had a plus minus del f is equal to plus minus del x plus minus del y, and that goes for addition as well as subtraction. In relative error, you had plus minus del f divided by f is equal to plus minus del x divided by x plus minus del y divided by y. That goes for your multiplication and division as well. And in case of constant, you will have plus minus del f is equal to c into plus minus del x plus minus del y. And relative error will be plus minus del f divided by f equal to plus minus del x divided by x plus minus del y divided by y. Okay, this was the case of error. Now, what we saw now is uncertainty case, which is here. So your absolute uncertainty will be del f is equal to under root del x whole square plus minus del y whole square, that is for addition as well as subtraction. Then relative uncertainty was del f upon f is equal to under root del x upon x whole square plus del y divided by y whole square. That goes for multiplication as well as division. In case of constant, you will have del f is equal to under root c under root del x square plus del y square. This under root c is coming because of under root. Okay, del f divided by f relative uncertainty will be under root del x upon x whole square plus del y divided by y whole square, which will be same. Here you can put plus minus sign as well, okay, which is by default. So you can see there is, both the things are same, just the way to calculate the error are different. So here we are squaring it and taking the under root, whereas here you are just simply adding it, okay, here also. So I hope this table gives you everything, means whatever thing we have seen till now, and you will be able to solve the questions.